Hi everyone, my name is Vivek and welcome to my YouTube channel. If you want to see my upcoming new tutorials, please subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon. This is the 7th episode about JavaScript basics. In the previous episode, we saw the difference between var and let keyword. Today, we'll work on the number type. So first, open your text editor and open the 7th folder number type. Open start and main.js. You can create a variable price and assign it to a number. So number data type can be any number without single or double quotes. To check the preview, we can write console.log and price. Now open the browser, open the developer tool, go to console and refresh the page. You should see 50 over here. Now let's work on type of operator. This operator is used to see which data type has been used. For example, let's create a variable and assign it to a number. In console log, you can write type of and the variable name, which is price2. Now, if you check the preview, you should see number data type over here. Now, let's add single quote in this number and see what happens. If you refresh the page, it should show string, because whenever you add single or double quote, everything becomes string. Now let's remove the quote. With JavaScript, we can work on mathematical operations. For now, let's work on addition. So create a variable and assign it to a value. Now to add them, you can write price3 equals price3 plus number. For now, I will write 1. To check the preview, we can use console.log price3. Now, if you refresh the page, you should see 21 over here. Likewise, we can work on subtraction. So create variable and assign it to a value. You can write price4 equals price4 minus number. Again, I will add 1. You can console log price4 and you should see 19 when you refresh the page. Now, let's work on multiplication. So, create a variable and assign a value. Add price5 equals price5 times number, let's say 2. You can console log price5. Now if you refresh the page, you should see 40 over here. Let's work on division. Create a variable and assign a value. Price 6 equals price 6 divided by number. Let's add 5. You can then console log price 6. Now refresh the page and you should see 4 over here. Now let's work on the modulus. It basically shows the remainder value. So first, let's create a variable and assign a value. You can write price7 equals price7. The sign of modulus is percentage and a number. I'll write 3. Now if you log price7, you should see 2 as a remainder value, because if you divide 20 by 3, you should see 2 as a remainder. Refresh the page and you can see 2 over here. Likewise, we can use shortcuts while using operator. First, create a variable and assign a value. Then you can write price 8 plus equals value, for example number 5. This is similar to writing price 8 equals price 8 plus 5. Now let's use console log price 8, and if you refresh the page, you should see 25 over here. Likewise, you can use shortcut in other operators as well, for example subtraction, multiplication, division and modulus. Now let's see how we can use multiple variables easily. We can simply separate them by comma. For example, let's create a variable rate and assign a value. Then you can add comma and assign another variable quantity. Now if you use console log, you can simply write rate times quantity. Now if you refresh the site, it should show 100. Likewise, let's work on the negative number. So first, let's create a variable and assign a value. And you can subtract minus 5. So you can put minus 5 under a bracket. Now, if you use console log, two negative numbers become positive. So the result should be 25. So refresh the site and you should see 25 over here. Great. This is the end of this session. In the next session, we'll work on operator precedence. Feel free to comment below if you have any question. Also, please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to my channel to get more videos in the future. If you want some hosting companies, you can check the link below. Thank you and see you soon.